Jesus. Hallelujah. We give you all the glory. We came to give you all the praise. Oh Lord. Come on, lift your hands up to him tonight. Seated in his presence. Hallelujah. 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 You're the beautiful rose of Sharon. What a wonder you are. You're the beautiful rose of Sharon. What a wonder you are. You are, oh Jesus, what a wonder. Worship him for a minute. Somebody just worship him for a minute. Somebody just worship him for a minute. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. You may be seated in his presence if you can. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. God, you're so good to us. Such an awesome God. He's a miracle-working God. It's a God that's never failed us. I'd like to honor Jan and Paul tonight. Dottie and all of my brothers and sisters behind me. So good to see everybody. To all of the people of God in this place tonight. To everybody that is watching by way of television, watching by way of the internet. Process of coming to the telethon. I think Jan is quite aware that I'm really led of the Lord and accepting speaking engagements, and this is no different than any other. I felt that the Lord had something prophetically that he wanted to say. Because I believe strongly in the full office of the prophet. That if God doesn't have anything to say, you don't have anything to say. When the Lord impressed in my spirit that he had something to say, my responsibility became to prepare myself so that I would not be a hindrance to what the Lord wanted to say to the nation. It's not just to a body of people. It's not just to a denominational race or culture. It is to a nation. It is going all around the world. And that's why we must take every opportunity that the cameras bring us to make sure that we understand that this is to people all over the world. And where we sometimes in America take for granted the word that the Lord delivers unto us, there are people in other parts of this world who hang on every word that comes across this platform. And we as believers are held responsible for every song that we sing. I believe that we ought to really become even more intense about what we deliver and how we deliver it. Because you can sing the right song at the wrong time, and it doesn't help anybody. Become a sounding brass and a tinkling cymbal. You can reach back into your black book and get a message that you've preached before. And the last people that shouted, it means nothing to the people, because times and dispensations change us.
circumstances change us. The atmosphere in this place today was not like it was when I was here 2 weeks ago, because the Spirit of the Lord changes the atmosphere. When the needs of the people change, the Spirit of the Lord change. And that's why it was necessary that God deliver unto his people fresh manna. A right now word. A right now word to meet the need of a right now situation and a right now problem. And so the believer has got to be about the Father's business, and we got to understand the times that we are living in. And this is not the time to play church. This is not the time to play preacher. This is not the time to pretend like God is sending you with a ministry, because it's time for the Christians now to stand up and reach out to a dying world. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. What we need now is not another superficial anything. Woo! My God, I feel something in here tonight. Because you got people hurting. You got people that are suffering. You got people that are still shouting and miserable and about to commit suicide right in the church. Because the Bible tells us that the letter alone killeth, but the Spirit bring life. And there is a revival that is taking place in my prayer room. It was so intense, I had to keep walking out of the prayer room. I had to keep leaving out, because the Spirit of the Lord now is wooing. It's in travail. It's about to bring forth this next thing that God is about to do. It's going to be done by the divine power of God, not by a man, not by a denomination, not by religion, but by his Spirit. The Spirit of the Lord began to let me know. He said, see, the people of God don't understand this. And that is the way that I'm going to take the church higher, the way that I'm going to call the church to become elevated in power. If I am not allowed to bring trouble at the door, because something has to happen to you physically that causes you to feel like you want to give up, to get your flesh out of the way. And when that happens, the Spirit of the Lord will begin to take over, and you're walking under his power, because without him, you wouldn't make it. And so we got people saying, Lord, take me higher. But when trouble comes, we act like it's all the devil. No, the Bible said what the devil meant for harm, God would turn it around for your good. Okay, I'm going. Jesus. So I begin to feel his power. I mean, I couldn't hardly go in prayer. I would feel his power. I wasn't even trying. I wasn't even in no great worship. But I can feel his power. And what he began to give me was the word for this telethon. He said, what you are experiencing is the power of divine release. He said, because the next thing that I'm going to do is not going to be done by man. It's a divine release. And except you receive it from the Lord in the Spirit of divinity, you can't release it into the divine. Okay, sit down, because I got to teach this tonight.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
When the Spirit of divinity begins to go in operation, it is not for you. That which is divinely given can be divinely released.
All right.
I'll tell you what I'm talking about. Go with me to 2 Peter, show you something. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God gonna do something in here tonight also. You're watching tonight. Divine release is about to hit your house. The first verse says, divine release, honey, is going to hit your spirit tonight, sweetheart. See, and the reason why I may not be preaching to everybody, because you know what? Everybody is not desperate enough. See, I'm not talking to people that's got it all together. I'm talking to somebody in television land and right here that said, I'm on the verge of giving up. And what I'm going through right now, I'm desperate and I need an answer from God. As a matter of fact, can't nobody help me? Them the kind of people I'm talking to tonight. I'm talking to the people that are saying, can't nobody help me with this one? If God don't do it, it can't be done. I need a divine release. I need something to feel. Sit down for a minute. Simon Peter, a servant, I'm reading from the Amplified Bible, and apostle, special messenger of Jesus Christ to those who have received. I'm reading 2 Peter, the first chapter, and the first verse, and I'm reading in the Amplified Bible, so it may read a little different, but it's a baby in the orange right there. A divine release is coming in your house, honey. Lift your hands up. A divine release. Honey, you've been bound for a long time. A divine release. Woo! My God, a divine release. And let me tell you something about this power. This power is so major in here tonight. Everybody's sitting around you. Everybody's sitting on your row. It's going to be affected by your divine release. Come on, come on. Come on, people of God. He said, I ain't came to play no games now. I hope y'all ain't trying to play telethon, because I'm not playing here. Simon Peter, a servant and apostle, special messenger of Jesus Christ to those who have received. He's talking to those who have received, obtained an equal privilege of like precious faith. With ourselves in and through the righteousness of our God and Savior Jesus Christ. I'm talking, the scripture is talking to the people who understand, not the people that emotionally feel. Because something can come along and knock your emotions out the window. He said, I'm talking to people who understand that you have already received a like precious faith. How does it come? How do you get this kind of faith that is unwavering? How do you get the kind of faith that the devil can't knock it down? How do you get the kind of faith that can stand up against anything? Because this is not the bubblegum faith that somebody tell you to slap your neighbor high five and tell your neighbor, I got the faith. This is the kind of faith that you get when you walk in righteousness. That's the reason why the Bible said that the prayers of a righteous man availeth much, because a righteous man walks in a faith that cannot be shaken. Okay, sit down. Cause this is a fixed faith. It's a faith that comes by condition. This ain't the one where you lie, cheat, steal, and do all of that, and still say, honey, ain't nobody gonna shake my faith. No, this is the one that it doesn't matter what you feel, it still comes to pass. This is the kind of faith that you can still shout Because you understand the principle of the faith of the righteous. What is the principle of the faith of the righteous? The principle of the faith of the righteous is when God says it, it's supposed to go the opposite way. Because what God says, his word has to be tried. You don't hear me. You don't hear me. You don't hear me. It's got to be proven that what God says stands against the fire. It stands up against lies. It stands against persecution. It stands against sickness. It stands the test of doubt. Okay, watch this. Watch this. Father, help me tonight. Father, help me tonight. Not moved. Not moved by what I see. See, the righteous faith is not the faith of prostituting God. The righteous faith is not the faith that says, do it like this, God. And then when God don't do it like that, you feel like God failed him. The righteous faith says, do it like this, God. And if God chooses not to do it that way, the righteous still have the audacity to praise God. Because if God didn't do it the way I said do it, then apparently he's going to do exceedingly and abundantly above all I can ask or think. He ignored me because he got something greater for me. Feel something right there. I said he ignored your request because he got something greater. So when it don't happen, I shout. I don't hear nobody talking to me. I don't hear nobody talking back to me. When it don't come the way I think it should, I praise him. You don't hear me. When the doctor give you a bad report, you give God the glory because I already got a word given to me that I shall not. Sit down, because I got to get to this. See, this kind of word right here separates the religious people from the righteous. Oh, I'm going to help somebody right here. This kind of word separates the traditional quote-unquote Christian from the righteous, because the Christian don't want to go through nothing. The Christian want everything and don't want to suffer and don't want to get into anything. But Christ went to the garden and said, God, if it be your will, let this cup pass me. But nevertheless, God, not. Here it comes now. Here come the faith of the righteous, because the faith of the righteous said, nevertheless, not my will, but I got faith enough to tell him. Woo, it hurts so bad right now. I can't see my way right now. I don't know how this thing gonna turn out, but I got the audacity to say, nevertheless. Okay. See, y'all sit down, because you know the amens, the praises got real low. Okay, I'm gonna tell you. Sit down. Let me just read this to you. Come on, we going somewhere right now. Let me just read. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Quit. Give up. No, I don't think so. I'm the righteous. Okay. Okay, watch this. It says, the second verse says, may grace God's favor. Yes. Okay, I'm finna talk here. May grace God's favor and peace, which is perfect well-being. Perfect well-being, all Here is the key word, necessary good. Because see, we want a lot of stuff that ain't necessary. God, give me a Rolls Royce. That ain't necessary. I'm not hearing nobody talk back to me. I'm not hearing y'all say nothing. God, give me an 8-bedroom house. That ain't necessary. It ain't necessary because you haven't matured to the level of, to have that. So what I want you to do is get back to what's necessary. Okay, sit down, because I'm going. Oh, necessary, good and spiritual prosperity. Whoa, spiritual prosperity. Everybody's talking about natural prosperity when the Holy Ghost is trying to get somebody to have a desire for spiritual prosperity. I want to be anointed more than ever. God, whatever you got to do, I want to be able to pray more than I've ever prayed before. Give me the power to pass. Give me the anointing to lay hands on the sick. God, anoint me to change a nation. God, help me to go before kings and queens and speak your word. I want spiritual prosperity. I'm preaching hard. Yeah. Sit down, because I got spiritual. Woo. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Spiritual. Okay, so then, somebody said, well, you know what? Well, then, what is Seventh Hour all about? Spiritual prosperity.
Yes.
Because you know what? Just because we touch so many nations last year, if we don't do no more than we did last year, then you know what? We haven't spiritually prospered.
Yes.
God don't want us to just maintain. He wants us to keep moving.
Yes.
I'm not hearing y'all talk back to me in here. Because then people don't begin to see the revelation. They begin to treat TBN and Christian television like it's reality TV, waiting to see what else gonna happen next and who gonna say what and who gonna do what. And you're not concentrating on the fact that you are responsible for spiritual prosperity in the nation. But because we got people telling us, you're going to get a house, you're going to get a car, touch your neighbor, God going to give you some more money, and you got money, but you bankrupt in your spirit. You got cars, but you still ain't going nowhere in your spirit. You got clothes, and now you too cute to praise God, and you too dressed up to worship, and now you don't want to go to the slums, and you don't want to go to other countries, and you can't in less than a 5-star hotel. The devil is a liar. God is crying out tonight for spiritual prosperity. Sit down, because I'm going somewhere with this. You're going to get a divine release tonight. Woman of God, man of God, you listen tonight. You're going to get a divine release tonight, because you know what? Right now, we are in trouble because we're putting the cart before the horse. But the Bible told me when I was on my face before God to tell the people, when you get to TBN, that it's time to go back and seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And then, I don't get nobody saying, and then, no, you don't pray for a car. No, you seek God for his righteousness. Because when you get right, he said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his sin. No good thing will he withhold from them that's not on the hustle in the kingdom. To them that walk it upright before him. Okay, watch this. Sit down, because we. I just got to get to this. Stay right there. Don't turn the channel. Don't turn the channel. Don't turn the channel, because divine release is about to hit your house. I'm talking to everybody in this room. Don't turn the channel in your spirit. Don't turn the channel in your spirit, because divine release is getting ready to hit your house. You represent a church. You represent a house. You represent a family. You represent a culture. Divine release is getting ready to hit everything that you connected to. I hear the Bible say, but I'm about to perfect those things which concerns you. Matter of fact, if you believe that, if you believe that, I know it's a little tight in here. You may be sitting next to somebody that just came to see the show tonight. And just, but if you believe that, just break out and go to praising God. I mean, out of your spirit. Okay, let me help you with something. See, just now, this man threw his seed out in the flow.
Thank you, God.
That proves my point. That which is divinely given is the only way you can divinely release. See, the devil got you clogged. Because we're trying to work it out in the natural. We're trying to work this thing out. Who am I preaching to? Trying to fix it. You got some stuff that you know that God has given you an assignment. And so then you start trying to fix it. You know, I gotta fix it. If I go over here and I get this little bit and I put this over here and I take this from this and put that over there. And so now we're irritable and we're frustrated and we're tired. You know why? Because we don't understand that the same God that spoke that word to us, it was a divine assignment. Therefore, it shall be divinely financed. And we're trying to take something natural and finance something spiritual, when the only way that it's going to take place of something spiritual has to happen on the inside of you, that helps you to understand that when God gave me something, I've got to release something, because if I don't release it, it is my only witness that I am authentic in the spirit. Okay, I just said something. Sit down, because I got to say that again. Sit down, because you got to hear me say that again. Sit down, you gotta hear me say that again. The only proof, that you have, that you have been called of God, that you are the righteousness of God, is that the divine power of God, he gives you the unction to release. You don't hear me. I don't think nobody heard what I just said. As a matter of fact, there should be times when you stop yourself because you can't hardly take it no more. Because the higher you go in God, the more you release. The higher you go in God, the more you look for somebody to pray for. The higher you go in God, see, it's them low people that's got a low prayer life that's always looking for somebody to give me something, give me something, give me something. But when you are truly bona fide, to sow into the kingdom. When you're the righteous, it comes with your righteousness. It is a built-in. Okay. Sit down. Sit down. Let me just. It's. You know I'm right, right, lady? You know I'm right. The lady that's doing it. You know I'm right. It's something that triggers. It's something that happens to you when you can't help yourself. It triggers something. See, in order for us to really be able to prove that we are the righteousness of God, and we said we walk like Christ, the Bible said as he walked the streets, he was moved with compassion. He couldn't pass up anybody that had a need and he not reach out. You don't hear what I'm saying? And when God requires that this network go all over the country, God has a need. How dare you say, I don't feel the unction to release? Because a house that's the body against itself cannot stand. How is it that God is telling us to go? And you're only required to watch us go, but not help us go. I'm not hearing nobody talk to me right there. I just wish I had somebody in the audience to just say something. To just say something. You know, the bigger the capacity get in your spirit. I can remember when I started out in the storefront churches preaching. And I remember how I kept sowing. Because you know what? I wasn't sowing for a big house. Listen, when I'm doing ministry, I live in a 3-bedroom house on a regular block. I wasn't sowing so God can give me a Bentley. I drive a truck and that's my only car since my husband bought me a little Beetle. You know what my desire was? I kept sowing because when I received the prophecy according to Jeremiah 1 that I was a prophet called to the nation, I was no longer satisfied preaching in America. I know now that the Lord is calling me to other nations. I cannot be still. Oh, you don't hear what I'm saying. God is calling me to Africa. I got to go to Africa. I got to go and feed the hungry. I got to go preach the gospel. TBN is taking me to Africa. How dare you sit and say, Africa got a need. And God has a call. And you don't feel the power to release. Okay, sit down because I got to. Let me finish this. Sit down. Oh, they done got quiet in here. You didn't. Because I'm going to help you right now. I'm going to help you right there in television land. There are people out there right now that God is requiring that you give $1,000 seed. Well, if I give it, what am I going to get? A divine release. You don't hear me. I don't think nobody heard that. Because I felt that in my belly. I felt that in my spirit. I felt it down in my belly. You got to understand something. That when God starts requiring that you release something, it's because he's got something packed up and waiting to release to you. And God is saying, if you don't release it, I can't give it to you. Somebody said, well, I beg the difference. No, I beg the difference. You wait a minute here. God didn't wait and wait until he got his return. He gave his only begotten son before he ever reaped anything from the human race. Oh, God, I'm not hearing that. Thank you. You need to pick up the phone right now while I'm preaching. You need to pick up the phone right now and start sowing it. There is two people that God is talking to. He said there are Gideonites in the spirit. That's a mighty army that will sow a 300-faith seed dollar offering. But there are many of you that God is talking to. He said the $1,000 seed is your breakthrough seed. It is your divine release to see. And I don't have to repeat myself. You already know who I'm talking to. The Holy Ghost said you're waiting for something to get bigger. And you're waiting for it to get better. And it ain't going to get better as long as you keep it in. in your pocket. But when the Spirit of the Lord falls in your house, that's God shaking the water. You can't step in the water and come out of your dilemma unless God troubled the water. And tonight, the water is troubled. God is ready to give you your divine release. What did he say? What did he say? I'm going to help somebody right there. I'm going to help somebody right there. Watch this, because some of y'all need to get this. Divine. Divine. Watch me now. Divine. What does divine mean? The dictionary says that divine means that which comes from a supreme being, that which is called God. Watch this. That operates with no assistant from man. Okay. Ain't nobody say nothing like that. Because I'm preaching to somebody at home right now. I'm preaching to somebody at home right now that don't understand what I just said. I said the way it's gonna take place, the way it's gonna happen for you, woman of God, the way it's gonna happen for you, man of God, that's sick in your body, is that it is going to be something that comes from God without the assistance of man. You don't hear what I'm saying, because God is saying it's time for the nation to get to know who he is. You know who your uncle is, where you used to borrow money from. You know who your pastor is, who used to help you pay your rent. Man of God, you know who your buddies are in the kingdom that help you put a new wing on your church. But this time, God has put the body of Christ in a position that the next thing that God does is going to have to be divine, or it's not going to happen at all. He said, watch this, he said, spiritual prosperity and freedom from fears and agitating passions and moral conflicts be multiplied to you in the full, personal, precise, and correct knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. Are you listening? No, you didn't hear that. You didn't hear that. You didn't hear what I just said. All the things that I just named. Well, y'all low, because you know what? Sometimes we've been in church too long. Some of y'all that's watching, you've been in church too long. Because you done forgot how to hear a word and know that it's God. Everything I just named, he said, that is going to be multiplied. Okay, y'all didn't, you still didn't get that. Not tomorrow. But as I am speaking it tonight, prosperity and freedom and fears, deliverance from fear and agitating passions and anything that mess with you and anything that aggravates you, I don't think you hear what I'm saying. The things that you have need of, God's getting ready to multiply it. Honey, God's getting ready to multiply you. Listen, let me tell you something. The thing that you've been going through, tonight the Lord said it's over. Tonight it ends. He said he's turning your situation around, and he's getting ready to multiply. Now, what does he say? Sit down, because this is the best part. 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 If ain't no lines available, keep calling. Because you need to divinely release right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just felt that in the building. Hallelujah. I gotta say it one more time. The water is troubled. For somebody watching, you better get your wallet. It's troubled. You better shut your ears to the devil and say, yeah, that's television. They just want some more money. No, it isn't. The Lord has sent a prophet to tell you that tonight your divine release, it takes place tonight. Tell you what. Let me tell you why. Sit down. Sit down. Let me tell you why. God, have mercy. God, have mercy. God, have mercy. What's $1,000 when everything you've been believing God for is getting ready to be multiplied? I don't think you hear what I just said. I said, what's $1,000? What's $500? What's $300? You better get up out of your bed and find the seed. You better get in your purse and write a check. I don't care if it's $16.13. What is that in comparison that when I release it, because it's been divinely given, a word has been divinely given to you tonight. And if you release what the power of the divine is in operation, it'll happen tonight. It'll start now. It'll start now. Anybody sick in your house, God will heal their body right now. Let me tell you this. Sit down, sit down. Let me tell you this. Lord, I got you. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Listen. Now, here it goes. Here it goes. Are you ready for this? Y'all still with me? Because some of y'all divinely releasing. Some of y'all divine. Hey. Are y'all still with me? Are y'all still with me? Because something has happened. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Watch this. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Let me just finish this. Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Here it is now. Here's a secret. Come on, pick up the phone because I feel you. I feel you. I feel you. I feel sick bodies. I feel sick bodies being healed. Right at home, right at home, right at home. I feel sick bodies. I feel cancer. In the next 30 minutes, I hear the Holy Ghost say, somebody getting ready to start throwing up. God's getting ready to purify your blood. I hear the Holy Ghost say, AIDS is being released. You may not have but $5, but tonight you got a divine release. Oh my God, I feel the Holy Ghost in here tonight. Somebody better start praising God. I feel the Holy Ghost in here. Somebody got a divine release. You watch and just don't watch. Get up and sow. Get to the phone. Keep on dialing. Because God said tonight is your night for divine release. Let me show you. Let me show you. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Woo. Lady. Oh. 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 I don't know who you are. Go get me that shawl. I don't know who you are, lady. Shandarado Shanta. Kenarado Kuya Tamaha. Oh, Katanabosha. Yes, Tatanabosha. He can't. Sit down, sit down, sit down. Sit down. Sit down. The next time we call to the nations, the next time I shout Kenya and God has given Kenya a breakthrough. The power of God is going to ricochet around the world. You don't get what I'm saying. I said the power of God is getting me to ricochet around the world. The Holy Ghost said they need a prophet to come and prophesy. The next time I shout that, because TBN and I are in covenant relationship to go to a dying nation, you better start praising God, because you may not have no money in this building, but when you release your praise, that means you just I gotta give it to you. For his, here it is. The third verse, my sister said. Sit down, y'all gotta sit down. You sit down, you push me in the anointing. And I gotta finish this. He said, for his divine power has bestowed upon us all things that are requisite and suited to life and godliness through the full personal knowledge of him who called us by and to his own glory and excellence virtue. Now watch this. Watch this. Watch this. When I saw this, and then I saw this. Watch this. Watch this. I'm going to prove it to you. I'm going to prove everything I'm saying. Just stop walking for a minute. Stop walking for a minute. Stand still because you got to hear this. Nobody else move yet. By means of this, by means of these, he has bestowed on us his precious and exceedingly great promises, so that through him you may escape by flight. Now, some of y'all didn't get that. That means that when the spirit of the divine step in, the stuff that would have taken you years to get out of. Okay, let me bring it to you now. Some people get delivered by bus. Some people get delivered by car. Do you get my point? Some people take them by train, and it take others a long time. But God said tonight, when you hear the prophetic word and the spirit of the divine step in, you're delivered by flight, which means what would have taken you years to come out of a situation, he brings you out in a hurry. Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. So then what he's saying is that the divine release that is in here tonight, Jan, is a by flight release. I don't think y'all, did you hear me? Did you hear me in television land? Did you hear what I just said? Did you hear what I just said? The Holy Ghost said it's a by flight deliverance. You don't hear what I'm saying? Ain't nothing right now quicker than a plane. I said, it's about flight experience. So what am I talking about? If you went from Atlanta to California to take you a couple of days, I don't think y'all hear what I'm saying. But anybody that flies know that I can get from one side to the other in a matter of hours. I don't think you just heard what God said. And when his power says, I will divinely deliver tonight by flight, that means in a matter of hours. To help me. If you in here tonight, if you're watching my television, the Holy Ghost told me to prophesy that in a matter of hours, the power of God is about to deliver you. In a matter of hours, not tomorrow, in a matter of hours, you better praise him. You better glorify him. Yeah. at your neighbor right quick. It's that neighbor. In a few hours, something about me is getting ready to change. No, come on. Turn to your next neighbor. It's that neighbor. In a few hours, I'm walking into my deliverance. I'm walking into my victory. You right there at home, run around your house and tell the devil, in a few hours, God is going to deliver. Sit down. Sit down for a minute. God, I feel the Holy Ghost in here. I feel the Holy Ghost in here. Some of y'all don't believe the prophet tonight. I feel the Holy Ghost in here. In a matter of hours, cancer is going to be healed. In a matter of hours, HIV is going to be sent back. In a matter of hours, depression is coming off. In a matter of hours, somebody getting up out of their sick bed. I'm talking to somebody now in the hospital room, in your kitchen. In a matter of hours. That. Sit down for a second. How do I know that? How do I know that? How do I know that? You got to release something. No, I'm talking to you. Come on, hear me tonight. You got to release something. You got to release it now. What's $1,000 in exchange for eternal victory? Let me tell you something. Call, pick up the phone right now. You need to go to the phone. It's time for you to sow, because in order for God to give it to you, you got to divinely release something. What is a divine release seed? It's a seed that I can't afford to give. It's a seed that I don't know if I should give it. The reason why I'm giving it, I'm not giving it according to my budget. I'm hearing somebody say, but it ain't in my budget, but it's your time. It's your time for a release. Pick up the phone, dial the number. Don't let the devil keep you one check away from your breakthrough, one check away from your deliverance. Pick up the phone. It's a divine release. Somebody come on and bless him. Your house, something gonna come out of your purse, something gonna come out of your account. Listen, listen, sit down for a minute. Sit down for a minute. Sit down for a minute. The divine release. Somebody said, divine release. Listen what he said. Listen what he said. Listen what he said. He said, you shall escape by flight from the moral decay. From the rottenness. Lord have mercy. From the rottenness and corruption that is in the world because of covetousness and lust and greed, and become sharers. Watch this. And become sharers. Listen to me. And become sharers and partakers of this divine nature. I don't think you just heard what I said. I don't think you just heard what I said. And become sharers and partakers of this divine nature. Now, if I become a sharer of this divine nature, then what am I saying? What am I saying, brother? The scripture said in the 20th verse, listen to this. Yet, first, you must understand this. That no prophecy of scripture is a matter of any personal or private or special interpretation, loosening and solving. For no prophecy ever originated because some man willed it to do so. It never came by human impulse. But men spoke from God, who were born along, moved and compelled and impelled by the Holy Spirit. What God has spoken tonight is not a prophecy. prophecy that's been provoked by man. It is a prophecy that have been impelled by the Holy Spirit. Because I don't care how much we try to fight against it. It is the nature of God that he asks us for something. I don't hear nobody talking right there. We try to act like that finances is not a part of the kingdom of God. It is his way of asking us for our heart. Because the Bible said, wheresoever man's treasure is, there also lies his heart. And let me tell you something. Whatever you believe in God for, if you can't believe God to release a seed for 1,000, he'll never trust you with 1,000,000. Oh, my God, I just said something. If you can't trust God to provoke you to release a seed of $300, he'll never be able to trust you with a ministry. Because this is your testing ground. This right here is your proven ground that, God, I trust you more than what's in my pocket, and I'll release it if you require me to, because I know you're taking me to greater things. Tonight is your night for divine release. You need to pick up the phone right now. You need to dial the number that's on the screen. You need to tell the devil, you'll never trick me again. I've sat in church for Sunday after Sunday, and I've given nothing to build the kingdom, but God, it's my turn. It's my turn for you to take me to another level. Who am I talking to tonight? It's my turn, God, for you to do something for me that you've never done before. It's my turn for a divine release. And let me tell you something. When you release something that is precious to you, God, I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. The operators are standing by right now. Pick up the phone. Because except what you see people coming in here doing, what you see people in this audience doing, is because the first mistake that we make as believers, we stop trusting God. We stop believing the word of the Lord, because we say, some of you don't even know the massness and the vastness of this network. You don't even know that this right here is not about money in our pockets, but what about the people that are in other countries and lands that we just put a satellite there and they've never heard the gospel? God, I'm talking to somebody. And the Bible tells us that we ought to go into the highways and the byways. But the scripture said it is our turn to become a partaker of the nature of God. And his nature says, if you don't trust me now, you'll never be able to trust me later. You sitting there, all of your bills are due. You sitting there with a $300 seed. When you don't even know that what you got in your hand is your favor. God, I feel the Holy Ghost. It is your favor. You don't even know that your last seed, the seed that you give with pressure, is your favor seed. I'm not hearing nobody talk to me right there. Because a lot of times, you know what? You can give 500 when you got 50,000. You can give $20,000 when you're a multimillionaire. But when you're down to your last, God, I'm talking to somebody right now. When your ministry is in a financial deficit and you don't have no place else to turn, the seed that you got in your hand right now is your favor. It is your only that causes the gates of hell to be broken. When God gave his only begotten son, he came back with all power in his hand. The only way that you can get the authority back in the area of finances, God has allowed you to be right here. You say, I don't know why I'm here. I don't know why I'm down to my last. I don't know why. I don't know if I should give 1,000. I don't know if I should give 300. I don't know. I don't know if this is my last $100. No, it isn't. It's your seed of favor. I can remember when, and I've told it before, My seat of favor came. And I said, God, I know you're calling me to television. And I don't have the money to go on television. He said, I want you to pull out a seat of favor. He said, I want you to empty your account and sow a $25,000 seed into somebody else's television ministry. And I obeyed God. And the Lord has opened the door. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You trying to figure it out one way. And you got a plan laid out. And your plan has already failed. God, I feel the Holy Ghost right there. You put it all together and thought that's the way it was going to work out. And the enemy has fought you on every hand. I'm talking to somebody right now. And now you let the devil give you one last battle of releasing a divine seed. You need to rebuke him and pick up that phone and tell the devil, the seed I got in my hand cannot pay my bills. The seed I got in my hand cannot bring me out of debt. The seed I got in my hand cannot cancel the situation that I have. But I can release this seed, and the power of God and his divine spirit can take this seed and multiply it. You sitting there struggling, and you sitting there debating, and the Holy Ghost has already spoken to me that there are 7,000 people that I'm watching right now. 7,000 people that God said, I'm requiring that you release this seed of divine release. And you watch and see. You release that seed by 12 o'clock midnight, and God will begin to turn it around. I don't think y'all believe what I'm saying. I didn't get this off the top of my head. I got it on the floor. You pick up that phone. Get your phone call in before 12 o'clock midnight. Don't you sit there and wait, because God said by midnight tonight, divine release goes into operation. Why do you say that, prophet is mine? Because of your obedience. The Bible said that Jesus learned by the things that he suffered. He learned obedience by the things he had to render. The only way you can learn obedience, you got to obey. You may not see it. You may not can figure it out right now. You may not even understand, why did I ever turn this channel on? Why did I ever turn it on? I don't even know if I should do this. I don't even know if it works. But I promise you this much. You've tried everything else. You don't have no place. You're already at the end of yourself. I'm talking to women right now that are single mothers. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I'm talking to women right now that are single mothers. You trying to make ends meet, but I hear the Lord saying, listen, you got to listen, y'all. The church has got to go back into believing miracles. And that's the reason why we got to get our spirits up out of the basement. We got to get our spirits up out of the basement. Because if we don't, the only thing that pleases God is when we move by faith. You don't hear what I just said. I said the only thing that pleases God is when we move by faith. If we move by sight, that doesn't please God. It pleases the Lord when you move by faith. And because we're spiritually low, we don't know how to trust God. That's the purpose of God elevating us in the spirit, so we can learn how to trust him. And you watching now, you need to go to the phones. Operators are standing by. Single mother, I'm talking to you. You saying, you know what, I don't hardly have anything. I don't even know where I'm going to get. I listen, prophetess, this is all I got left. All I got left is a $100 seed. All I got left is a $300 seed. You pastor, you evangelist, you businessman that I'm talking to, you businesswoman that's sitting there and suffering, you got $1,000 in your checking account, and you right at the last bit. But I promise you, if you turn it over to God and give it to God, he said by 12 o'clock midnight, the waters are troubled for you. Pick up the phone. The operators are standing right there. If the line is busy, keep dialing, keep dialing, keep dialing. Because it is your turn and your hour and your season for your divine release. What you have been waiting on is a divine word. Because you don't have 6 months to figure it out. You don't have 3 months to figure it out. You need a divine answer right now. Somebody lift your hands up all over this building. Lift your hands up all over this building. All over this building. Begin to praise him right now. Begin to magnify him right now. If you're in this place right now, but you know that the Lord has given you a divine release, come on, open up your mouth and begin to worship him. Open up your mouth and begin to glorify him. Come on, I don't hear you, saints. Come on, I don't hear you. Come on, begin to worship him. Begin to worship him. Begin to worship him. Begin to worship him. Come on, open up your mouth. Grab somebody by the hand and tell them, I'm in divine release right now. I'm walking in divine release. Come on, come on, you gotta magnify him. I'm walking in divine release. Come on, tell somebody the Lord is doing something for me. He's divinely working something out for me. Come on, you gotta worship him tonight. It's out of your spirit that God is releasing. You've already laid your seed down. You've already brought your seed to the altar. Now get your hands up and begin to praise him. Because you're walking in divine favor. You're in divine release right now. You're in divine release right now. Come on, worship him. Come on, you right there in your house. While you got the telephone in your hand. Your answer is to worship him. Your answer is to praise your way out. And your answer is to release the divine seed. Come on, release it. Come on, release it. Come on, release it. It. Come on, all over the building. I feel the Lord in here. Come on, release it. His presence is all over this room. His presence is right there in your house. Come on, while the water is troubled, pick up the phone. Pick up the phone and dial your victory. Pick up the phone and dial your victory because God is doing it now. Come on, somebody worship him. God's going to give you a divine release. He's doing it now. I'm talking to some more people. God's giving you a divine release. He's giving you a divine release. Tonight is your night. Lift your hands up all over the building while I pray for these people. While I pray for the people that are watching. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, God. I thank you for your divine release. I thank you because you're a man that can keep his word. I thank you, God, because you've never failed us. I thank you, God, because you've never let us down. And now, God, all over the nation, deliver your people everywhere. Cause them to come into their divine release. Cause them to understand that when the water is shaken, the Bible said that when the man laid by the pool, waiting for somebody to put him in, the Bible said that an angel came and troubled the water. And when the waters got troubled, the man was placed in the water and made whole. Hallelujah. Tonight in the spirit realm, the water is troubled. Tonight, God, you designed an open door for somebody to get out of their situation by flight. You designed an open door for somebody to be let out of a cage of depression. You designed a door for somebody's sick body to be healed. And you're calling that to take place by divine release. So, Father, I charge them all over the nation that they would pick up the phone and obey your voice and not try to figure it out in their minds, but say yes to your will. And your will shall be done. And according to the inspiration of your word, by 12 o'clock midnight, every person that calls and release a divine release seed, you shall begin to divinely release it back into their hands. In Jesus' mighty name, let the people of God begin to shout in this place. Let the people of God begin to shout in this place. Let the people of God begin to shout in this place. Shout in this place. Shout in this place. Shout in this place. Lord, y'all praising God. I this place. Even by this time tomorrow, you will be provoking your friends and your brothers and your sisters to call.